on sense for sale. Where did we stash our brain cells?
You know, it's simply amazing, right?
And the Lord's Prayer postulates inter alia: Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, blah, 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 blah. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, blah, blah, blah. The power and the glory, forever and ever. One ecumenical creed goes like: Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Mother of God, the Alpha and Omega. Talk about the Holy Trinity and all the rest of them. Where did we stash our brain cells? Do all of these provide answers to all existential questions? What good do we make of encrypted dogmas, except to breed and groom peerless nitwits, bigots of yesterday, today, and tomorrow? We sure do know of warning notices in the days of yore, in the citadels of freedom, on signboards, even road signs and markings. No loitering, no trespassing by law. Trespassers will be prosecuted. Yet we forgive those who trespass against us? Where did we stash our brain cells? In the cerebellum, and medulla oblongata? Isn't it doctrinal to believe in life everlasting? Could there be a narrow path to a heaven paved with gold, with angels touted as the Creator's abode, and still be everywhere with us in spirit? Yet who came to live amongst us as an only begotten Son, who was crucified on a cross to atone for our sins? What sins? Where did we stash our brain cells? Underground? By the roadside? Or in the marketplace? Well, whichever way or place that may be, we better begin to count our cowries in gold, to buy what has always lived in us, even in the minds of old, in the youths and those yet unborn. One question to ask: where did we stash our brain cells?
If your clients are not paying you, then they are playing you. Listen attentively without me hearing you. Though it is not certain, you certainly take a cue. Presumably, all persons know of its existence. However, those in search are a few. They seem to have it in abundance. Yet, when it is needed, they begin to dance. They become celebrities overnight and twist their constituents into fans. Inform your allies who are supposed to be lawmakers that they are now troublemakers. If the citizenry trivialize issues worth accountability and permit to be led by persons on pension, they become complicit in the wallows of economic tension. Just like a modest response to a thank you, oh, don't mention. Imagine it as an illicit drug sold clandestinely. It has zero expiration date and only needs to be used at the right time. If over or underutilized, it might result in the commission of a crime. Humanity is gradually affirming nonsense in bits in the name of research. Which search? Why search for something that has already been found? Is it to make us stay relevant and profound? One thing for sure is that sense, like any other commodity, is not free. Do not halt the flow, no matter how deeply embedded it is in your family tree. Just like the seasons, sixth sense in turns. Likewise in cooking, lack of turns cause burns. Anything questionably questionable, that is answerably answerable, has to be sensibly sensible, otherwise it becomes terribly terrible. Therefore, I say to you without offense, apply your sense, for it has no fence. Whenever, wherever, or however you find sense for sale in your quest to make a purchase after authentication, be wary. Do not bargain. Caveat emptor. Buyer, beware.